Dave here from Llamachant Technology. One of the first things we learn about in XAF is scope and controllers. Because we use view controllers more often, I'm going to focus on them, but the same basic concept applies to window controllers. By default, view controllers are active on every view in the application. It doesn't matter if it's a list view, detail view, dashboard view, or whether the view is rooted or nested. This is where scoping is essential to ensure it's only active on the views where it's needed. In this example, I'm adding a controller with a simple action that will display the current view ID. Once the application is running, you can see this action becomes available in every view. There are four basic options for scoping a view controller: by view type, object type, view ID, and the view nesting. Initially, XAF had four target properties available for us to use in a controller's constructor for scoping. We'll review these properties first, but it's important to note that there's a new way of scoping a controller through generic type arguments that we suggest using instead of the target view type and target object type properties. Let's start by scoping down to a particular view type. In this case, we'll make this controller only active on list views. You can see that the Show View ID message action is available on each list view. Next, we'll scope the controller down to a particular object type. In this case, we'll make this controller only active on contacts. The action is now available on the contacts list view, as well as the client's nested list of contacts. Let's go ahead and scope our controller's target view nesting to nested. The action is still available in the client's list of contacts, but the action is no longer available in the contacts list view. This is because the list view must be nested within another view. Finally, we can roll back all of these changes and specify a particular view ID instead. If you want to specify multiple view IDs, you can separate them with a semicolon. Now that we have an understanding of target property scoping, let's have a look at the generic type argument scoping instead. We prefer this method of scoping because the view property in our controller will automatically cast to the specified view type, and the view current object and view selected object properties become available and are also casted to the specified type. To use the generic type arguments, you can inherit from the view controller with a particular view type, or the object view controller with a particular view type and object type. If you want your controller to work on list views and detail views, you can set the view type to object view. Finally, if you want to make your controller reusable and scoped out to several objects, you can implement an interface that you apply to all relevant objects. Now, our action is available on the clients and contacts without having to implement separate controllers.